Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 13.3 and iOS 13.3.1 Beta 1 have been out for a couple of weeks, and we haven't seen any updates since. Now, Apple has been pushing out updates at a rapid pace, but right now, because it's the holiday season, a few days after Christmas, and then we're running into the New Year season here in the United States and around the world, we're going to see a kind of slow release of updates until probably the week of the 6th. Now, it's possible they could put something out before the end of the year, but most likely it will be the week of the 6th where we see a beta update. So beta 2 or something along those lines, or maybe even a final release, but usually they'll do a lot of betas first. Now, I want to talk about my experience with this overall on my iPhone 11 Pro Max running the beta, and then also the 13.3 experience that most of you are experiencing. I went back to the YouTube community polls and was surprised to find that people keep commenting and then actually voting. There's over 20,000 responses now, so 23,000 and over 600 comments. So I went back and read some of those comments to see how recent they were, and they're within the past week or even sooner. So I was really excited to see that many of you are still commenting and letting me know how it's going for you. Now, over the past week or so that I've been using the beta, it's been great on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. So I'll talk about the beta briefly, then I'll talk about 13.3, and then we'll talk about some of your experience as I went back to those community polls. Now, my experience with 13.3.1 Beta 1 seems to fix quite a few issues, at least for me, mostly that I was experiencing with 13.3. So for example, I was having that issue where I was switching from Wi-Fi back to LTE and it was always glitchy, but over the past week, I've had zero issues. Initially after installing the beta, I had an issue, but now if I turn off Wi-Fi, maybe go to Safari here, we'll go to my website here and it loads right away. Let's load another one so you can see it's not cached and it's loading. So it switches over immediately now. So I don't know if they pushed something recently. This seems to only be within the past week. When I initially installed that beta, I had issues. So I'm not sure what's going on, but I'm glad to see it's fixed. The other thing is I've been having some weird issues with email still, unfortunately. Sometimes it'll say two. I'll go into the mail app. Nothing will be there, but then they'll show up a little bit later. So there's still some issues with that. I'm not sure why there is, but there definitely is a few issues here and there. Now, a major issue I'm having with iOS 13.3.1 Beta 1 is with the speakerphone. I've seen this numerous times, and anytime you place a phone call and use speaker, or you use FaceTime because it's using the speakerphone, the person on the other end says there's an echo and they really can't hear you or understand you. The only way around this is to use the earpiece here or to use AirPods or some other sort of wireless Bluetooth headset or something like that, so the person on the other end can hear you clearly. This is a major issue with Beta 1, and I highly recommend you don't update to it until they fix it, probably with Beta 2. I think it was just an oversight. They probably tweaked something and didn't realize that was broken. So that's what the beta tests are for, and make sure you submit feedback if you're having those issues. I think I put feedback in here somewhere. I'm not sure where I put it. There it is, in my utilities. So at the end of my utilities, there's feedback. Make sure you use feedback and let Apple know that that's a problem so that they can fix it. Now, if we talk about iOS 13.3, I'm running that on my iPad and my iPhone XR and some other devices. But on my iPad, I've been having some weird rotation issues. For example, when I lock the iPad, unlock it, I could be in landscape and sometimes it will force itself to portrait mode. I've seen this a few different times, and I've also seen some touch bugs return where I'll go to touch the screen and it just doesn't do anything. So I could open an app and then sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, and then it's really hit or miss. It's very strange, and if I reboot it, it fixes it, but this is a public release, iOS 13.3, and I'm still having issues with it on my iPad. Now, on the iPhone XR, I'm not really seeing any issues, and between both of them, I'm seeing phenomenal performance. But there's some issues with battery, according to you. I'll share my battery life in just a moment, but performance has been great on both. You'll see if I open the App Store on both, it wasn't open on this device. If I open the App Store, maybe we'll go into the web browser. It takes a second to open. We'll open the weather, and you'll see nothing was open here, but it catches up quickly because everything is performing well. Heavy tasks are performing well, and most of the time I've had no frame rate issues or anything like that. But I know that's not the experience of everyone. But before we talk about your experience, let me show you the battery life I've had with the beta, because a lot of you are saying we definitely need an update to this version, 13.3.1, because of battery issues. So my battery has been okay on this beta, and it's improved over the time I've used it. Now my battery health is still 100%. This is the phone I use every day, daily, and I wirelessly charge it all night long, and it just seems to work. And then if I'm driving, it's in my car wirelessly charging. Otherwise, it's not charging. So you'll see over the last 10 days, this is today, under 25% of the battery has been used, and I only have 2 hours of screen on time. So if we multiply that, say, by 5, I'm getting about 10 hours. If we take a look at this day, I had 6 hours of screen on time, and I used just over, well, between 50 and 75% of my battery. So about 65 to 70% of my battery, and I had 6 hours of screen on time and almost 2 hours of screen off time, 1 hour and 47 minutes. So I'd say that's pretty phenomenal. A lot of that was photos and uploading and things like that, and I've had no issues whatsoever, and I found it to be very good, especially as time goes on, and I really don't change any settings. I just turn off background app refresh on apps I don't use regularly. I do leave background app refresh on some of them. So really, the experience of the beta has been great. I want them to fix mail, and maybe for some of you on older devices, battery life, particularly the iPhone 7, 6S, SE, the older devices seem to have some issues. Now, as far as the YouTube community poll, let's take a look again at that. And if we go into the poll, you'll see here, like I said, we had 23,000 votes, and this is on the regular public release version, 13.3, 605 comments. If I go to the comments, let's go down here. And what I'll do is I'll sort this not by the oldest first. I meant to sort it by top comments. The top comments are the ones that are voted for the most. So that means 57 people voted for this, saying battery life has been terrible on 13.3. It's been 2 days of getting 7 to 8 hours of screen on time instead of the regular 10 to 12 on iPhone 11. However, most people get 7 hours of screen on time or 8 hours on the iPhone 11. So it just depends on what you're doing on how good the battery will be. On the iPhone 11, people that I asked online on Twitter had said about 7 hours was pretty average, just in general. So if you're getting 10 to 12, that's incredible. Normally only the pros do that. Now, the next thing is data and Wi-Fi connection randomly dropping since the release of iOS 13. I've seen this more with 13.3, and I forgot to mention this. I've had a few people over the past couple of weeks ask, why is my phone disconnecting or what can I do about it? And I actually suggested they reboot their Wi-Fi router, and it seemed to help. Most of the time it fixed the problem for them. So I don't know if it just needs to reinitialize or re-handshake that connection to fix it. But I've seen this a lot over the past many years and years ago, even with iOS 4 and things like that, or iPhone OS, when Apple would update it, it would cause problems with things like Cisco routers when I worked in that industry. And then we'd just have to wait for an update from Apple or Cisco to fix that. So they just keep changing things and it messes it up for everyone. If you go through all of these comments, you'll see many people complain about battery life. I would say just wait for this next update, the 13.3.1 update. Hopefully that'll be out within a month or so, so everyone can hopefully have better battery life and Apple can improve that over time. If we take a look at the beta here, the beta again has 20,000 votes, so thanks again for voting. And this one only has 163 comments, but if we take a look at the top comments, we'll give it just a moment to load, and you'll see using an iPhone 11 Pro Max and having a lot of cellular connectivity issues. My coworker just got a Samsung Galaxy Note 10 on T-Mobile like me. Right next to each other, he gets 40 megabits per second. My iPhone struggles to get 15. I talked about this in the original follow-up video, and that's mostly because things like the Samsung Galaxy S10s, like this one, has a Qualcomm modem in it, and it's much better than the Intel modems that are on the iPhones. Hopefully next year we'll see that fixed, but I wouldn't expect a software update to fix this at that point. At this point, it seems to be more of a hardware issue, going back to the 10S even. So unfortunately, Apple had to use those Intel modems due to a lawsuit, and it will be fixed in the future. Now, a week ago, someone said iOS 13.3 was in the battery life for me, so people were commenting about 13.3 on the beta poll as well. Now, as I mentioned earlier, someone said when using speakerphone during a phone call, the person on the other line hears their voice echo. That's still true, as I mentioned earlier, so just keep that in mind if you're going to update to the beta. Hopefully they fix it with beta 2. So I would expect an update. We may see it this coming week. I would think it would be more likely the week of the 6th, but that's hard to say for sure. We don't really know for sure what Apple's going to do next, but be sure to check back. I'll keep you updated with all those updates. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.